Dear students, today we are going to study about cost classification. Firstly, what is cost? Cost means anything which is given or sacrificed to obtain something. But in cost accounting, it has a specific meaning. A cost is incurred when a resource is used for some purpose. In other words, when a business enterprise produces or sells goods or service, it incurs cost. Thus, in cost accounting, the term cost refers to the resources consumed to produce a product or service. Then, classification of cost. These are the some needs for the cost classification. They are, first one, cost classification helps to ascertainment of profit periodically. And it also helps to prepare budgets and a planning process. Cost classification helps to control the cost of the business organization. Then cost classification helps to determine effective pricing policy. Then the cost accounting also helps to application of plans and policies in an effective manner. Then, what is cost classification? Cost classification is the process of grouping cost according to their common characteristics. That is, cost classification is the process of grouping cost according to their common characteristics. There are various ways of classifying cost. Following are the various bases of cost classification. The first base is classification of cost on the basis of element of cost. On this basis, the costs are mainly classified into four. First one, material cost. Material cost are the cost of any materials we use in the production of goods. We divide this cost further. For example, let's divide material cost into raw material cost, spare parts cost, cost of packaging materials, etc., etc. Second one, labor cost. Labor cost consists of the salary and wages paid to permanent and temporary employees in the pursuit of the manufacturing of the goods. Third one, direct expenses. All the expenses other than material cost and labor cost associated with making and selling the goods and services are called direct expenses. All other expenses other than material cost and labor cost are known as direct expenses. Fourth one, overheads. Overheads are indirect charges. These are the aggregate of indirect material cost, indirect labor cost, and indirect expenses. These are the operating expenses. Overheads cannot be directly charged to a specific cost center or cost unit. Then, second one, classification of cost on the basis of function. On this basis, the costs are mainly classified into six. First one, production cost. Production cost comprises of all the direct and indirect cost incurred in the production of goods and services. That means these costs are associated with production of goods and services. Second one, administration cost. These costs involved in the management activities of an organization, like electricity, stationery, telephone expenses, rent, etc. These are also known as administrative overheads. Third one, selling cost. The indirect cost incurred on the sales functions of the goods and services, like advertisement, promotion, customer service, etc., are clubbed under selling cost. Fourth one, distribution cost. Distribution cost refers to the cost incurred for making the goods and services available to the customers. These are warehousing, delivery services, transportation, etc. Next one, finance cost. It is the cost, interest and other charges involved in the borrowing of money to build or purchase assets. That is the total expense associated with securing funds for a project or business arrangement may include interest payment, financing fee charged and fees and salaries of any personnel to complete the financing process. This is known as finance cost. Then the last one, research and development cost. Research is essential to develop a new product or modify an existing one. The cost incurred on the research team, research implementation, findings, etc. come under this category. These are the classification of cost on the basis of function. Then next one, classification of cost on the basis of controllability. On this basis, the costs are mainly classified into four: fixed cost, variable cost, semi-variable cost, and one more item, step cost. First one, fixed cost. Fixed cost are those costs which do not change with the changes in the volume of production. When production increases or decreases, the fixed cost, that is total fixed cost, will remain fixed. However, it may vary according to time. Hence, fixed cost is also known as time cost or period cost. It should be noted that fixed cost remain fixed only up to certain level of activity. It may vary in the long run. It also be noted that fixed cost per unit will change with the change in the volume of output. That means total fixed cost will remain fixed, but the fixed cost per unit will change with the change in the volume of output. The second one, variable cost. Variable cost are those costs which vary directly with change in the volume of production or volume of output. This means that when a volume of output increase, total variable cost also increase proportionately and vice versa. Similarly, when the volume of output decreases, total variable cost also decreases proportionately and vice versa. But the variable cost per unit remain fixed. Okay, total variable cost always vary according to volume of output. On the other hand, variable cost per unit remain fixed. And the third one, semi-variable cost. These costs are partly fixed and partly variable. The best example for semi-variable cost is telephone charge, power charge, depreciation, etc. These costs remain fixed up to certain level. After that, these costs vary according to levels of output or levels of activity. Then the fourth one, step cost. Step cost are those costs which increases in step. These remain fixed over a range of activity. Up to a particular range of activity, these costs remain fixed. And then jump to a higher level when level of activity increases beyond a certain point. Step cost is also known as chunky cost. Step cost is a variant of semi-variable cost. The best example of step cost is electricity. That means up to certain level, the electricity charge remain constant. After that, it jump to a increasing point. Then this is known as step cost. These are the classification of cost on the basis of controllability. Then next basis, classification of cost on the basis of normality. On this basis, the costs are mainly classified into two, normal cost and abnormal cost. First one, normal cost. Normal cost is a part of the cost of production and part of the costing profit and loss of the organization. These are the costs that the firm incurs at the normal level of output in the standard condition. This is the normal cost incurred in the normal level of output in the standard condition. The second one, abnormal cost. These costs are not normally incurred at a given level of output in condition in which normal level of output occur. These costs are charged to the profit and loss account. They are not a part of the cost of production because this is abnormal cost. Then the next classification is classification on the basis of identifiability. On this basis, the costs are mainly classified into two, direct cost and indirect cost. The first one, direct cost. Direct cost are those costs which can be conveniently identified with a particular cost center or cost unit. These are directly charged to a product, activity or department. Material used for the production of a product are common example of direct cost. Then second one, indirect cost. Those costs which cannot conveniently be identified with a particular cost center or cost unit are known as indirect cost. These are common to a number of cost center or cost unit. They are to be apportioned on suitable basis to different cost center or different cost units. The total of indirect cost is called overhead. Factory manager salary, factory rent, etc. are the typical example of indirect cost. Then next one, classification of cost on the basis of investment. Classification of cost on the basis of investment. On this basis, the costs are mainly classified into two, capital cost and revenue cost. First one, capital cost. Capital cost are the fixed one-time expenses incurred on the purchase of land, building, construction and the equipments used in the production of goods or in rendering of service. In other words, it is the total cost needed to bring a project to commercially operable status. That is, capital cost is the cost for purchasing fixed asset. Then next one, revenue cost. The term cost of revenue refers to the total cost of manufacturing and delivering a product or service to the customers. That is, it is the total of manufacturing cost plus cost of delivering product or service to the customer. That is the total amount incurred to earn revenue. Then the next classification is classification on the basis of time. On this basis, the costs are classified into two, historical cost and predetermined cost. Historical cost are the costs which are incurred after the event take place. They are nothing but actual cost. Historical cost are the actual cost. Then predetermined cost. It is the cost which is computed in advance of production. A predetermined cost is also known as standard cost. Standard cost is computed or determined in advance of production. Then on the basis of association with the product, on this basis the cost are classified into product cost and period cost. First one, product cost. These are the costs which are directly associated with the product. These are the cost of making the finished products. Example of product cost are direct material, direct labor and factory overhead. Thus, these are manufacturing cost. Second one, period cost. These are the cost charged as an expense in profit and loss account of the period in which they are incurred. These costs are transferred to the profit and loss account of a particular period in which that expense incurred. They are incurred on the basis of time. Example, insurance, depreciation, etc. Then next and last one, classification on the basis of decision making. On this basis, the cost is classified into different types. First one, sunk cost. First one is sunk cost. S-U-N-K. Sunk cost. Sunk cost are historical or past cost. These are the cost which have already been incurred as a result of decision made in the past. This is the past cost or historical cost. Such a cost cannot be reversed or revised by a future decision. These are not relevant for decision making. This is known as sunk cost. The second one, out-of-pocket cost. Out-of-pocket cost. Out-of-pocket cost are those costs that involve cash flow immediately or in future. That involve cash outflow immediately or in future. Material cost, labor cost, repairs, rent, insurance premium, etc. are the example of out-of-pocket cost. Then next one, opportunity cost. Opportunity cost is the value of a benefit sacrificed in favor of an alternative course of action. It is the cost of best alternative foregone or the cost of foregone alternative. It is the value of benefits foregone when one decision alternative is selected over another. For example, if an old building is proposed to be used for a new project, the likely rent of that building, if it is rented out, is the opportunity cost. Then the fourth one is imputed cost. Imputed cost. These are the hypothetical cost or notional cost. That means these are computed for decision making purpose only. These costs are not actually incurred. These are expenses which an entrepreneur pays to himself. These are not recorded in the books. The example is rent on owned building, salary of owner, interest on owned capital, etc. Then next one, marginal cost. Marginal cost. Marginal cost is the additional cost of producing an additional unit. It is an extra cost for producing one additional unit. Then next, sixth one, replacement cost. Replacement cost is a term referring to the amount of money a business must currently spend to replace an essential asset like a real estate property or an investment security, etc., with one of the same or higher value. That means it is the cost incurred for replacing an existing asset. Then seventh one, avoidable and unavoidable cost. Avoidable cost is a cost that is not incurred if the activity is not performed. That is, if there is no production, there is no cost. This is known as avoidable cost. On the other hand, an unavoidable cost is the cost that is still incurred even if the activity is not permitted in the organization. It is incurred if the activity is not performed in the organization. Example, fixed cost. This is avoidable and unavoidable cost. Next one, differential cost. Differential cost. The difference in total cost between two alternatives is called a differential cost. Differential cost is the difference between the total cost of two alternatives. Then next one and ninth one, relevant and irrelevant decision. Relevant and irrelevant cost. Sorry, irrelevant cost. Cost which have direct influence on the decision making are called relevant cost. These are the future cost that will change due to managerial decision. For each decision, the management must decide which cost are relevant. That means relevant cost are directly influencing on the decision making process of the organizations. On the other hand, irrelevant cost are those costs which are not relevant in decision making. The example, sunk cost. Sunk cost are already incurred cost or historical cost. They are not relevant for decision making. And the last one, conversion cost. Conversion cost. It is the cost of converting raw material into finished product. Thus, it is the total of direct labor cost, direct expense and manufacturing overheads or factory overheads. It may be noted that conversion cost exclude the cost of direct materials. Direct materials are excluded from conversion cost. It is the cost of converting raw material into finished product. Okay, these are the different classification of cost. Okay, thank you.